No more delay. Servants, take them inside.
No!
No, please.
Blessed are those whose lifespan has not tasted evil. For when a house has once been shaken by the gods, no form of disaster is lacking, but it spreads over the bulk of the family line, just as when the surge is driven over the darkness of the sea by the fierce breath of Thracian sea winds, it rolls up the black sand from the depths, and the wind-beaten headlands that front the blows of the storm give out a mournful roar. I see that the ancient sorrows of the house of the Labdakidae are heaped upon the sorrows of those who have wilted away. Each generation does not set its family line free, but some god hurls it down, and it has no relief from sorrows. For now, that light that had been spread over the last truths in the house of Ilibus, that ray of hope, in its turn, is mown down by the bloody dust of the gods below, by thoughtless speech, and by a fury in the heart. Your power, great Zeus, what human transgression can check it? Yours is power that neither sleep, the all-ensnaring, nor the untiring months of the gods can defeat. Unaged through time, you rule by your power, and dwell thereby in the brilliant splendor of Olympus. And through the future, both near and distant, as through the past, shall this law prevail. Nothing that is vast comes to the life of mortals without distaste. See how that hope, whose wanderings are so wide, is truly a delight to many men, but to an equal number, it is a false lure of empty-headed desires. The deception comes to one who is wholly unaware until he burns his foot on a hot fire. For with skill did someone once reveal the maxim, which now has glory, that evil, at one time or another, seems good to him whose mind a god leads to disaster. But for the briefest moment, such a man fares free of destruction.
But here is him, the last of your offspring. Does he come grieving for the doom of Antigone, his promised bride, and bitter from the deceived hope of their marriage?
We will soon know better than Seers could tell us. My son, can it be that after hearing my final judgment concerning your betrothal, you have come raging with full-fledged fury against your father? Or am I still near and dear to you in whatever I do?
Father, I am yours. You keep me upright with precepts good for me. Precepts I shall follow. No marriage will be deemed more important by me than you when you guide me well.
Yes, my son. This is the spirit you should maintain in your heart, to stand behind your father's will in all things. It is for this that men pray to sire in their homes children who are obedient, who recruit their father's enemy with evil, and give honor to his friend, just as their father does. For what has he sown except struggles for himself and laughter for his enemies? No, never then, my son, cast aside your reason for pleasure on account of a woman, an evil woman to share your bed and home. For what wound could strike deeper than an evil friend? No, spit her out as if she were your most hostile enemy. Go, let her find a husband in Hades. For since I caught her alone in this city in open defiance, I will not make myself a liar to this city. I will kill her. So let her call upon Zeus, who protects kindred love. For if I am to foster my own kin to spurn order, I will surely do the same for others' kin. For whoever shown his excellence in the righteous path will win praise from me. But if anyone does violence to the Lord, or try to dictate those in power, such a man will never win praise from me. No, whomever the city may appoint, in matters small and great, and in matters just and not, Such a man will never win praise from me. And I would feel confident that such a man would rule no less than one willingly rule. There is no evil than loss of control. It destroys cities, it overturns homes, and it breaks the allied spears into headlong rout. Therefore, we must defend those acting with power, and in no way can we let a woman defeat us. For it is better to fall from power when fated by a man's hand than to be called weaker than woman.
To us, until our ears are stolen out of it, you seem to say what you say wisely.
Father, the gods implant good sense in men, the highest of all things that we call our own. For my part, to state how you are wrong, to say those things is beyond my power and my desire. Although, another man too might have a useful thought. In any case, it is my natural duty to watch on your behalf all that men say or do or find to blame. For your terrible deeds forbids the ordinary citizen to speak such words as would offend you. But I can hear these murmurs in the dark. How the city mourns for this girl, saying, no woman ever merited death less than, none ever died so shamefully for deeds of such glory as hers, as when her own brother had fallen in bloody battle. Would not leave him unburied to be devoured by savage dogs. Doesn't she deserve the golden honor? Such is the rumor, shrouded in darkness that silently spreads. For me, Father, no possession has more honor than your prosperity. Please don't bear one mood in yourself. Please don't think your word and no other is right. For if one man who believes he alone has intelligence that in mind or in speech he has not pure, such a mind when laid open is always found empty. Allow a change in your heart. Please, even from me, a younger man who only thought may be supplied. By far, I believe it is best for men to be all wise by nature. In any case, even if it doesn't work out that way, it is good to learn in addition from those who advise you well.
My lord, it is honorable if he speaks wisely that you should learn from him, and that you in turn even should learn from your father. On both sides, there have been wise words.
Men of my age, are we then to be schooled in wisdom by men of his?
Yes. I mean, nothing which is not tried, but if I'm young, if you should look to my conduct and not my years.
Is it worthy conduct to respect those who are without order?
I do not urge anyone to show reverence against the wicked.
And isn't she in the grasp of that disease?
All the people of the city of Thebes deny it.
Shall Thebes prescribe me how I must rule?
See, there have you spoken so much like a child.
Am I to rule this land by the will of another than myself?
There is no city which belongs to one man.
Doesn't the city by tradition belong to the man acting with power?
You would make a fine monarch in a desert.
This boy seems to be fighting on the side of the woman.
If you are a woman, for my concern is for you.
You complete utter willing, charging your father, lay charges against him?
Because I perceive injustice wrong.
Am I doing wrong when I respect my own prerogative?
No, you do not respect them when you trample on God's honor.
But you did creature, submitting to a woman.
You will never catch me submitting to shamelessness.
You do, after all, words feed her case.
Yours and mine and all of the gods below.
You can never marry her, not while she's still alive.
And she'll die. And in death, destroy another.
What? Does your audacity run to open threats?
How is it a threat to speak against empty plans?
You will regret your unwise decisions.
If you were not my father, I would have called you insane.
You woman slave, do not try to cajole me.
You would hear you say and have done without a reply.
Is this true, Balamba Sabah? You will have no joy taunting me over and above my censure. Bring out that hated thing. She will die in the presence of a bridegroom.
No, not in my sight will she die. Don't ever imagine it. Nor will you see. and set eyes on my face again.
Indulge in your madness with whomever of your friends can endure it.
That man is gone, Lord Crane, in anger and in haste. A young mind like that is ominous when it is in pain.
Let him go. Let him plan something more immense that befits a man, because he will still not be able to save both the women.
Then the pair of them. Do you really intend to kill them both?
Not the one who did not have her hand in the burial. You're right.
And by what mode of death do you mean to kill the other?
I will take her where the path is deserted, unvisited by men, and entomb her alive in a rocky vault, sending out a ration of food, only as much as spite requires, so that the city may escape defilement. Then, praying to Hades, the only god she worships, she will either escape immunity from death, or she will know that it is fruitless labor to those who are in Hades' keeping.
Eros, the unconquered in battle. Eros, you who descend upon riches and watch the night through on a girl's soft cheek. You roam over the sea and among the homes of men in the wilds. Neither can any immortal escape you, nor any man whose life lasts for a day. He who has known you is driven to madness. You seize the minds of just men and drag them to injustice, to their ruin. You it is who have incited this conflict of men whose flesh and blood are one. But victory belongs to radiant desire, swelling from the eyes of the sweet-bedded bride. Desire sits enthroned in power beside the mighty lords. For in all this, divine Aphrodite plays her irresistible game.